find that any coherent collection of my work in progress has been presented as such. It doesn't have a title. It's all simply, I've been calling it maybe just the festival. But it has some themes that you can hear, and it has some themes that you can detect if you read the program as and so forth. I'm very excited about this. What my life's work is doing right now. We're going to have about 90 minutes of music today, and there'll be an intermission of however long the usual intermission is here, so it'll be just under 2 hours that we'll be here. I want to make some things very clear. There is no electronic music, per se, on this program. This is, these are what I call realizations. Basically, I programmed the computer to play the music. Music that was written at my desk in the conventional way, the way composers have written for centuries. All right? This is not computer music. In computer music, we use the computer to do what only the computer can do. And in fact, there are very few people alive who are doing genuine computer music. You understand? This is something that literally an 11-year-old can has done, and even I can do. I don't want you to go away from this concert thinking that you heard electronic music. This is conventional music in the sense of it's music written for conventional forces, cellos and woodwinds and marionette and orchestra piece. So it's neither electronic music, which is put together using tapes in special ways, nor is this computer music. This is conventional music in which I've used the computer to play the music. This is actually the situation that was predicted some 50 years ago by a group of composers in New York City, including Vladimir Zachevsky and Otto Luening and others. And they saw the writing on the wall, the situation in post-war America, and they decided that it was pretty grim, that it was not going to be very easy to get orchestral performances or any performances in the future. The whole nature of music and how it fits into society was changing. And they posited at that time that perhaps what we now might call electronic music or music country would be the way of the future, a way to try to get some sounds in some kind of format that the audience could hear. They couldn't have known the degree to which computers would develop. So what you're hearing today is actually more like conventional music than what they were suggesting would be in the future. But this, in a sense, is the real deal with regard to where contemporary composers are at. I've done the math for not this season, but the previous three, the San Francisco Symphony. Not any of those seasons has more than, not counting the music by the music director, has more than two works been done by a living American composer. Now, you don't need to know a lot about music to know that's pathetic. And that's my statement, my official statement to Mr. Thomas. His representation of contemporary music is pathetic, and that is typical. At one point in the program notes, you may notice I say, it's a situation that would be a scandal if it were not so common. So real composers don't get performances. They don't have opportunities. This is where we really are. And I really thank you for being part of what I hope will be some kind of future. When you're listening to these pieces, please be aware that I like to use silence in my music, and there are a few places where you might think the music is done when it isn't. Particularly in the last piece on the program, some composers are like this. Haydn is famous for that, and Ruthner. Maybe I'm pushing the envelope a little bit, but the last piece on the program is not just 2.5 minutes long. Please keep listening. There are a few other places where you might wonder. The vocal pieces that begin the second part of the program being represented with the computer's version of vocal sounds, they're rather cheesy. I suggest that you hear it the way people used to hear the exact same situation 400 years ago when vocal music first began to get out of control, as the singer may have thought it, and too difficult for them to sing. It began to be played on the organ, and indeed the computer sounds quite a lot like organ stops. So, yes, that's vocal music. I didn't put the text in the program because there's already such an extensive bunch of pages there. But those are vocal pieces. I suggest that if you're wondering how to listen to it, hear it as though it's organ music. There was a time when a lot of new, then contemporary vocal music was introduced on the organ. This would be perhaps a similar situation. If you're familiar with the harp, when you're listening to my harp piece, you're going to wonder, what are you thinking, Christopher? That really can't be one harp. You're right. This is in part a version for two harps. That isn't in program notes, but there are notes there that even the most expert player could not play. So yes, I know about that. Now, most of the sounds are pretty easy to identify, but the French horn sounds like an organ. So the beginning of the second, the third piece on the program, the second playback, that's supposed to be a French horn. In case you're wondering, it's not an organ. And in the voice echoes at the very end, there's a very cheesy sound that the computer provides for glissando. It goes, meow, meow. I decided to leave it in because it's necessary to understand the music. That's not what I had in mind. It's supposed to be a kind of rip, like the electric guitarists sometimes play. So in case you're wondering, that really doesn't sound very interesting. I agree with you. But it's there because that's as far as we made it. I have a guest book that I bring to all my events, readings, concerts, that I'd really love it if you would sign in to, please. In the back, it's all red, and the delightful young lady will steer you to it. I have records and CDs to sell as well, if you're interested in any of those. I have the last few records from the entire run of Mandibles that I recorded some years ago on vinyl, Walter Winslow's entire book of 19 Mandibles, and there's my Modernism Forever as well. If you'd like to be included on the mailing that I'll be making when I do a CD of this concert, which will have other items on it as well, then you can sign in on the list there. And that CD will have the Mother's Day piece, which didn't fit on the program, which is already 90 minutes long. But there is a piece dedicated to Mom, and that piece will be available to all. So the last thought I'd like to leave you with, which will make sense when you read the program guide, go with appearances.